It was that first November 2014 when I woke up with a heavy heart and about some issues of life, and I decided to withdraw myself to a prayer chalet where I normally hold my retreats called Alone with God at the outskirts of Abuja. I left that place 15 minutes to 6, and the only thing I can remember was me returning the key on my way out. I remember somebody telling me, it's too early for you to get a vehicle going towards my direction. That was just the only thing I could remember. Bottom line, I just saw myself in the hospital. When I tried getting up from the bed, somebody stopped me. He pointed at my leg. I just realized my right leg was badly broken. I had injury on my head, which within that space of time, it was hard for me to remember a lot of things, and I went back. After a few days, I was discharged from the hospital and I went back home. A lot of people came around and they began to tell me things that really happened. And then the person who really came on the scene, one of my friend Kabiru Ata, he was out on his own business in Kogi State when that police or FRS called him, and they brought him on the scene. And when he came, he said actually I was laid alongside with others who were assumed dead, and he was just called to come and identify my body. And when he came, he said, I'm opening you up, he realized I moved a little, so he brought it to their notion and noticed that I wasn't dead. I read it like, since the spirit of him that raised Jesus from the dead lives in me, he quickens my mortal body, he vitalizes my mortal body. So right there, just meditating on that scripture, I remembered how that when Jesus died, every fiber of his being stopped working. His eyes stopped seeing, his ear stopped hearing, his leg couldn't move, his lungs stopped pumping and all of that. But when the Holy Spirit came into him, everything came back alive. And that same Holy Spirit is the one that I have living in me permanently. So he just have to do the same thing he did for Jesus, you know. And I kept saying, I have to keep using Ezekiel 37, bone to bone, sinews to sinews, let everything come back to normalcy. And then since God said, I shall have what I say, I was just saying it more again and again. Precisely on the 12th month, what happened was that I had to take a bold step. I had to take a bold step of dropping one crutch. I dropped one crutch first, and I was just going about with just one. So I keep using one for like 2 months. And when I did that, on the 14th month precisely was when I woke up one Saturday morning and I had in my heart to go to the kitchen and make a cup of tea without using any aid, which I did. And throughout that Saturday, I didn't use any crutch. And on Sunday, good morning, I stepped out, went to church without using any crutches. In fact, I think I took a class for about 45 minutes, and then that was just the end of it. One of the books that within that space of time that I was on my bed was that really helped me a lot was Christ the Healer. Now, at the cover of the page, it said, faith begins when the will of God is known. So I have to first of all dig into the will of God for my life concerning my health. My time in Rhema was really an eye-opener to a lot of things. And one of the things I understand about the system, or I realize about the system, is no matter how much you know, when you step in, you see how much you don't know. So they have a way of just opening your eyes to more realities about God. God is multifaceted, you can't know him all. So the things I got just working or schooling here really added a lot and saved me from going into the second surgery and also maybe having my leg amputated. So I'm saying that to God be the glory that today I'm not an amputee. I have my legs intact. I mean, both of them are equal. I can walk without any aid and I can think intelligently. I can remember what happened when I was as young. My training here in Rhema Bible Training Center added a lot and made me stand firm in the face of this adversity. So I give God the glory that I got to into Rhema Bible Training Center and I met people of like faith which were constantly there to, you know, steer me up, sharpen me up. I really want to say a big thank you to Rhema Bible Training Center for, first of all, pushing me to study Kenneth Hagin materials again and again, even though I've read it before, but the truth of God can never be outdated.